These two situations are very different. We have an intersection versus a union. With the intersection, we can see that is a small area where two events overlap or where they both occur. A union is a collection of all events or all outcomes in which either occurs or possibly both. So actually, the union contains the intersection. And that's sort of what brings us to these two rules of probability, the multiplication rule and the addition rule. Most importantly, we're going to look at the addition rule in this scenario. The multiplication rule really applies more to a repeated event. It's rare that you would use it in another scenario. So I'm going to start with the addition rule. We have the probability of either A or B occurring is P of A plus P of B minus P of A and B. To explain how we get this, let's look at the Venn diagram. If we want to find the probability of A or B occurring, or really being in this either of these circles, we could add P of A with P of B, and then we would have added this intersection twice. So it would be included in A and it would be included in B. So we actually overcount and we have to remove that intersection. So the addition rule contains really both the union and the intersection. Let's go back to that formula. We add P of A with P of B, and then we remove that intersection, which was double counted. Now, if the intersection is zero, or if they're disjoint, you could just add P of A and P of B because that would be zero. The way that would look in the picture, look at the two disjoint events. In this situation, you can get away with adding P of A and P of B and not doing any subtracting. With a deck of cards, let's look at those two scenarios. So something that has an intersection would be like aces and diamonds. If we want to add the probability of getting an ace with the probability of getting a diamond, we're actually counting the ace of diamond twice. So looking at the union or the probability of ace or diamond, we would take 4 out of 52 plus 13 out of 52 minus 1 out of 52. Now, we often don't talk about the fact that there's typically a much easier way to do it, and that's just tally them up. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 out of 52 in that union. If we look at something that's disjoint, we can just add the probabilities, like the probability of getting an ace or a 2. These are parallel to each other in this diagram, and they would have no intersection. They're completely disjoint or mutually exclusive. So the probability of getting an ace or a 2 is just 4 out of 52 plus another 4 out of 52. No subtracting needed, and if we tally it up, we see that that's 8 cards out of 52. Looking at the multiplication rule is a whole different thing. Multiplication rule tends to pertain to repeated events. So it could include the concept of independent events. Think about it this way. Let's say you were to draw two cards from a deck. You draw a card, you set it aside, and you draw another card. Let's say we want to find the probability of drawing two aces. Well, if we use the formula, we would be saying drawing an ace and drawing another ace. So we would start with the probability of an ace. That would be 4 out of 52. Then we would move on to the probability of the second card being an ace. That's going to be our B, given that the first card was an ace. So if we look over here, let's say we did draw one of these aces on the first draw, then we're going to cross one of them out. Doesn't matter which one. The main thing is that's going to leave us with only 3 remaining, and it's going to leave us with 51 total. So that's what the multiplication rule is typically going to be about, is when you repeat your draw, if you don't replace it, you need to adjust. So all this is going to mean is adjust your totals. Reduce the number of available cards that you can draw from and in the sample space. Now, if we look at, you know, replacing that card and reshuffling, then it's really just going to be 4 out of 52 times 4 out of 52. And that's because the probability of B given A would equal the probability of B, since those are independent events. Looking at contingency tables, we can kind of see a lot more about these concepts. So if you open this Google Doc, you have a whole bunch of different examples of contingency tables with events that are independent or disjoint, things like decks of cards, or students in a class that aren't quite as even of a count all the way around. So looking here, looking at the addition rule would be like either selecting a student who's running start or in their first three terms. We get that red and blue, and we see that intersection. So we can either tally these up. In that situation, we would avoid looking at the totals. We would say 4 plus 10 plus 3 is going to be 17 out of 25 that we have right there. Or we can add 14 plus 13 and subtract the 10. That would be using the addition rule, adding the P of A plus the P of B and subtracting the intersection.